Hello everyone, welcome to another video of this revision series. We are discussing hematological topics and today we will discuss hemoglobinopathy. Hemoglobinopathy literally means disease related to hemoglobin and it can be classically divided into qualitative and quantitative type. Qualitative hemoglobinopathy refers to alteration of amino acid sequence in globin chains. And quantitative refers to a particular globin chain is synthesized less or more. Qualitative hemoglobinopathy is also known as structural hemoglobinopathy, as we see in sickle cell anemia, where in the beta globin chain, in the sixth position, glutamate is replaced by valine. And quantitative hemoglobinopathy, the classical example is thalassemia. We will discuss it in detail. In newer classification, the hemoglobinopathy can be classified as structural hemoglobinopathy, thalassemia or quantitative hemoglobinopathy, thalassemic hemoglobin variants, that is structurally abnormal hemoglobin associated with co-inherited thalassemic phenotype, hereditary persistence of fetal hemoglobin, that is hemoglobin type fetal hemoglobin, HbF, increased in adults, and acquired hemoglobinopathy, that is carboxyhemoglobin. If we see some examples, like in sickle cell anemia, as we already told, in the beta globin sixth position, glutamate is replaced by valine, and the clinical feature is anemia and infarction. In HBC disease, similarly, sixth position, glutamate is replaced by lysine, and the manifestation is mild anemia, interacts with HbS or HbSc. HbE disease, here in the 26th position of beta globin, glutamate is replaced by lysine. And the manifestation is microcytic anemia, splenomegaly, thalassemia, phenotype. Another is rarely Yakima, here in the 99th position of the beta globin, aspartate is replaced by histidine. And polycythemia is the main clinical feature of this type of disease. Now we'll discuss briefly about thalassemia. Thalassemia, as you all know, is an autosomal recessive hemolytic anemia that results from quantitative defect due to reduced production of a particular globin chain. So clinically, it is of two types. As we all know, two types of globins are present, and thereby two types of thalassemia, alpha and beta thalassemia. In alpha thalassemia, there is a deletion of alpha genes, and the alpha genes are present on chromosome number 16 and it has 4 alleles. And in beta thalassemia, there is defect in transcription and translation of the beta genes, and these beta genes are present in chromosome 11 with 2 alleles. There are various types of alpha and beta thalassemia. Like in alpha thalassemia, types are silent carrier, alpha thalassemia trait, HbH disease, and hydrops fetalis. In silent carrier, among the 4 alleles of alpha gene, only 1 allele is absent or deleted, and its manifestation will not be seen. That is, it's almost asymptomatic, and thereby in hemoglobin electrophoresis, it's normal. In alpha thalassemia trait, 2 alleles are absent. In Asian type, in one case, 2 alleles are totally absent in one locus, and in African type, 1 allele from one locus and another allele from another locus are absent. And the manifestations are mild or no anemia, and in peripheral blood smear, we may find some abnormalities. And hemoglobin electrophoresis shows almost no abnormalities. In HbH disease, 3 alleles are absent. Thereby, the features are quite severe, severe anemia, and some features of hemolysis are found in HbH disease, and there is increased amount of fetal hemoglobin found in the hemoglobin electrophoresis. Another is hydrops fetalis. Here, all alleles are deleted or absent in case, and it is lethal in utero. And in hemoglobin electrophoresis, we find hemoglobin blast, that is the gamma 4 chains, are abundantly present. If we look for the various types of beta thalassemia minor, intermediate and major. In beta thalassemia minor, one thing that is, if beta is depicted here, it means normal beta globin synthesis. As we already told that in beta thalassemia, there is defect in the transcription or translation of beta genes. So beta indicates normal beta globin synthesis. Beta 0 indicates no synthesis. And beta plus indicates variable beta globin synthesis. In beta thalassemia minor, here is beta 0 beta type or beta plus beta. This any of the two types of genotypes are found. And features are mild or no anemia and some abnormalities of peripheral blood smear. Hemoglobin erythrophoresis is almost normal. Beta thalassemia intermediate is either beta 0 beta type or beta plus type. And severe anemia, regular transfusion is required here. Hemoglobin erythrophoresis shows raised HbA2 or raised HbF. In beta thalassemia major, beta 0 beta 0, beta plus either or beta 0 beta plus. And features are severe anemia and regular transfusion is also required here. So this is all about some basics of thalassemia. Thank you guys.